Teachers of Reddit, what's the worst fight you had to break up? The worst fight I broke up wasn't because of students getting hurt, but because of how lame it was. First off, I teach middle school, which is just one awkward moment after another. These two kids were arguing over a pencil, because one kid supposedly broke the other kid's pencil. They were bickering back and forth like two old men, and then they just broke out in really mediocre wrestling. It was embarrassing to watch, because neither boy could even wrestle, and I was able to just tell them to stop and send them to the office with no other issues. Another reason it was the lamest fight ever was, because all the other students who were working at other tables went about their work, and talking to each other, and didn't even notice. Usually they would be chanting fight, fight, over and over, and crowding around trying to film for World Star. I taught adults at a vocational school, mostly from rough neighborhoods. We had been warned to never try to break up a fight, as many of these students carried knives and so forth. Some woman had a bad falling out with her group of friends, and was sitting separated from them. They were talking back and forth, very loudly, very aggressively across the room. I couldn't control them, and went to get a supervisor. With me and the supervisor guy there, one of the girls from the group came across the room at the odd one out. She is big, 6 feet and 250 pounds, and charges across the room at the odd one out, who is maybe 5'2 inches. Supervisor gets in between them. They fight around him for a second, then smaller woman slashes the face of bigger woman with a razor or something. That pretty much ended it, other than a few thrown things and tussle, but a lot of hair and braids were ripped out and there was blood everywhere. Supervisor was lucky. They literally fought around him, and the smaller one whipped that blade over his right shoulder to slash the other one's face. This was on a Tuesday, and they were to effectively graduate on Thursday. Insane. I'm an English teacher in France. This happened in the classroom next door to mine, and I just witnessed the aftermath, and heard the gossip from my friend, who did break it up, and was there to hear the story, when they got hauled into the admin's office. One of my male students was named Timothy, who was dating a girl named Anna a year under him. One day last year he apparently left his phone unattended, and unlocked, and she picked it up, and started searching through it. What Anna found, was his very male best friend Louis sexting and sending him nudes, and talking about how much he loved him. And Tim was texting back, and being equally enthusiastic about the two of them being together out in the open once they finished school, and were in university. She proceeded to screenshot, and send all those texts, sexts and nudes to her boyfriend's parents, before replacing his phone, so he wouldn't know. Tim's parents are very conservative, and when I say very, I mean very. His mother once called me to complain about his grade in English, and it evolved into a rant about foreign students. That would make Marine Le Pen proud, and Anna knew, so that's why she went this revenge route. This kid went home to be blindsided thanks to her, and apparently he had to basically flee the house because he was afraid of his father literally killing him. Louis turned up to school the next day, calmly entered Anna's first period class, and beat the ever-loving shit out of her. Just wailed on her. He was skinny thing, but knew what he was doing, and she was super tiny, and it was not a fair fight at all, and he just obliterated her. I just heard him screaming, after he had been restrained witches, when I went to go check. She had a black eye and a broken eye socket and there was blood everywhere from her mouth and nose. Louis was borderline hysterical, and screaming about her being a bitch who ruined Tim's life. It was bad. I'm not a teacher, but I have worked in K-12 it for 10 years, so I have been in a lot of classrooms. Teachers aren't supposed to break up fights, and usually get hurt trying to do so. That being said, the worst fight I saw was in a science lab. I was in the back of the lab installing some software to go with a digital microscope, and a large 8th grade girl was singing disrespectfully while the teacher was talking. Tiny 8th grade girl behind her was getting pissed and telling her to shut up because she couldn't hear what the teacher was saying. Big girl continued to sing. Tiny girl says for the last time, "Shut the duck up, I'm trying to learn." Then proceeds to leap over the lap table between them, grabs the big girl's hair, and proceeds to bash her face into the table over and over again, screaming at her to shut the duck up. They had to get a very large male administrator in there to pull her off. The teacher got elbowed in the face when she tried to step in, said screw it, and ran out into the hall to get an admin. Fun times. My dad is a 5'6" Hispanic dude, gentlest person you can imagine. His first teaching job was at a rough high school. Two guys, both much bigger than him, got into it, but security was nowhere to be found, so he tackled them both in a bear hug so all they could do was stare at each other in rage, while my dad waited for reinforcement. Substitute teacher here. I was randomly assigned for the very last period of the day 2A. Difficult class. All of these kids were enormous. Like, maybe they were football kids. All I know is my petite self wasn't even shoulder level with these kids. So in a classroom full of enormous dudes, a few in the back kept picking on one kid in the front. The seriously huge kid stood up and charged at the super big kids in the back, who all stood up, ready to fight. My super lame reaction was to slam my tiny hands on the desk and yell, "Excuse me. Back in your seats, please." They all just sort of stopped and looked confused, and then sat back down. No fight. No problem. Nobody was more surprised than me. I ended up leaving them some good notes for their teacher because honestly, any enormous guys who stop their big ass fight, just because some tiny lady in a cardigan asks them to sit down, well, they can't be all bad. I taught English to adults older than me, and they got salty for the tiniest ducking reasons. It never evolved to be a physical fight, but holy shit, I'd rather teach children. They can be way more mature. I used to teach high school in rural Georgia. I had to break up a fight between two girls and a heavily pregnant girl. I never taught these girls, and it happened between classes in the hallway in front of my room. The pregnant girl was on the floor screaming and crying, while one girl was kicking her in the head, and one kicking her in the stomach. I grabbed each of them by their upper arms, and hauled them away very hard. One fell back on her ass and the other nearly fell. The one on her ass started crying about how I'd hurt her. The other girl acted like she was going to rush me, or the pregnant girl. I grabbed her, held her back, and told her that if she tried it again, I'd make her wish she hadn't. She tried to hit me, and I twisted her arm until she was on the floor kneeling and screaming. Meanwhile, one of the other teachers helped the pregnant girl and another called the nurse a principal. I was the only one to act for a good 30 to 40 seconds. I had a student who fought a few times in my class and was one of those blind rage type fighters who would just swing at anyone until he got back under control. He was manageable in my class, but he was sent to homeschooling after a fight he got into in the hallways. Something stupid set him off, and he punched the other kid a few times before being restrained by one of the security guards, who he also punched in the face. During the same fight, a teacher was trying to separate the two students, and he accidentally, but still, broke two of her fingers. It dawned on me that day why they tell us to not get between students fighting. She was lucky that one, she wasn't hurt worse, and two, that she wasn't written up on disciplinary charges for breaking that rule. Edit. Since this got a lot of attention, I'll clarify a few things. This is in an urban district on the East Coast US, and security guards are the norm. 223 per floor plus a roaming resource officer who is a full-fledged police officer. Cameras in every hallway and the lunchroom. The district is a former Abbott district, and something like 85% of the students come from economically disadvantaged backgrounds. A lot of the students have shitty or non-involved parents, so there's a ton of disciplinary challenges on top of teaching students who are mostly below level in basic things like reading and writing. Fights are commonplace, but this one was especially brutal. I've only broken up a few fights, and they were pretty mundane, but if there is one thing I know, is that girls' fights are worse than boys. Girls will go for your eyes, but boys typically stick to an honor code, no hits below the belt and all that. I had two girls fighting in my classroom. It turned into a hair pulling contest in my skeleton drive. Kelsey, Ian, life drawing class, wore one of their weaves for the rest of the school year. My mom had two 7th graders using chair legs to fence each other. Not a teacher, but in my low-income urban public school we had an actual riot, with students punching police officers, tripping the fire alarm, damaging property, and screaming obscenities. School was cancelled for 2 days as teachers reviewed security footage and suspended kids. Of course, it was a doozy to break up a lot of dissatisfied kids in the cities. I'm not a teacher, but my high school put a jukebox in our cafeteria 1 year, and for a dollar you could play 3 songs. So these 3 girls put in like, $5 and played 50 cents in Da Club on repeat. After the 4th or so repeat of the same song, some girl had had enough, and went to unplug the jukebox. The 3 girls literally jumped her right there, punches and hair flying everywhere. I'll give the one girl credit, she was holding her own against the 3 of them. This is all going on and that ducking song was still playing. Everybody's watching them kick the sheet out of each other. After about a minute in, some guy strolls over all casual like, and unplugs the jukebox. They stop fighting after that, and that song was never played again. The end. Actual teacher here. It was after school, and I was headed to the copy room. On the way is the cafeteria, which had been cleared of all the tables, and was basically just one big empty area, except for the huge mass of students that had developed. I rushed into the massive crowd, where 2 different circles had formed. It was literally like being at a metal concert with 2 mosh pits. At least 16 kids were fighting. When I broke through, one kid fell in front of me, and the guy who pushed him ran up, and did a Jinakowski kick to his head. All metal moshing instincts kicked in where my main goal was to basically push away as many people as possible, and keep them away from each other, until more apps or fears could arrive to help. It was chaos, so I don't remember much after that. To this day I don't even know why they were fighting. Once everything was settled, I picked my paper back up, and went back to making copies. I'm a school bus driver. My first year driving I got the bad school. Kids living in houses with boarded up windows kind of neighbor I pikes up in. But I was the only ride these kids had, and I loved them. A few small fights in the afternoon but nothing really bad all year till mid-June. I pull up to my first stop, and there's Tommy on top of his sister Jane. Tommy was in grade 1. Jane in grade 2. Their older brother Billy was yelling at them. I saw this from afar. I sped up, slammed on the brakes, AMD flew out of my bus without thinking. Ripped Tommy off of Jane. He still had the wire in his hand. He was trying to kill her. Now, being in the neighborhood I was in, I couldn't send him home. So I threw him on the bus, K not really, and made him sit up front with all other kids at least 3 rows away. Took him into the school. I held his hand and his sister's. And we walked into the principal's office. The principal seemed like he didn't care. And I didn't see Tommy the rest of the year. No one told me what happened. That was over 5 years ago. We lost the run to another company. So I don't know how he's doing. Just a quick note, Jane could breathe. No marks on her neck, and she was okay physically. Clear airway and all. Older brother Billy said it happened as I turned around the corner. I still think, if I had a cell radio I would've called 911.